Good afternoon. Welcome to our Wednesday Mass live stream. Let us prayerfully place ourselves in the presence of the Lord as we begin our liturgy. Our presider today is Father Vince. Let us now sing together our gathering hymn.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Oh, my soul, praise Him, for He is your help and salvation. Come out, would you prosper our work and defend us. Surely His goodness and mercy shall daily attend us. Ponder anew what the Almighty can do, will befriend us. Praise to the Lord, oh let all that is in us adore Him. All that has life and breath, come now with praises before. From His people again. Now as we worship before Him.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And welcome back, everybody. It's good to see you. Let us begin our Eucharist by looking into our hearts and asking for God's pardon and for God's peace.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in You, graciously hear our pleas. And since without You, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of Your grace, that in following Your commands, we may please You by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the book second book of Kings. When the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven in a whirlwind, he and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Please stay here. The Lord has sent me on to the Jordan. As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." Elisha replied. And so the two went on together. 50 of the guild prophets followed, and when the two stopped at the Jordan, they stood facing them at a distance. Elijah took his mantle, rolled it up, and struck the water, which divided, and both crossed over on dry ground. When they had crossed over, Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask for whatever I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha answered, "May I receive a double portion of your spirit? You have asked something that is not easy," Elijah replied. "Still, if you see me taken up from you, your wish will be granted, otherwise not." As they walked on conversing, a flaming chariot and flaming horses came between them, and Elijah went up to heaven in a whirlwind. When Elijah saw it happen, he cried out, "My father, my father, Israel's chariots and drivers." But when he could no longer see him, Elisha gripped his own garment and tore it in two. Then he picked up Elijah's mantle that had fallen from him and went back and stood at the bank of the Jordan, wielding the mantle that had fallen from Elijah. Elisha struck the water in his turn and said, "Where is the Lord, the God of Elijah?" When Elisha struck the water, it divided and he crossed over. The word of the Lord.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. How great is the goodness of that you keep for those who revere you, that you show to all who trust, and all the world can see. Let your hearts take comfort, all who shelter of your presence from gossip and evil plots. You keep them safe in your tent, away from disputing tongues. Let your heart take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. God guards those who love him, but in turn will repay to the full those who act with pride. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Take care not to perform righteous deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no recompense from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right is doing, so that your almsgiving may be in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, who love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on street corners so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go to your inner room, close the door, and pray to your Father in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others as fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that you may not appear to others as fasting, except to your Father who is hidden, and your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Your Father who sees in secret will repay you. I'm sure you recognize this gospel from Ash Wednesday. Every year we hear these words from the Gospel of St. Matthew, part of the Sermon on the Mount. We hear it each year, especially the part about not doing works of charity in order to be seen. And then we put ashes on our forehead and for the whole world to see. You know, it's kind of an interesting dichotomy. I don't know how that happens.
In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus contrasts the behavior of the hypocrites with that demanded of his own disciples. He says that the hypocrites blow a trumpet before they give alms, or before they pray on the street corners so that everybody can see them. And then they neglect their face. They don't wash their face when they're fasting. And Jesus says, they have received their reward, recognition, and praise for their good deeds. Now, Jesus tells his disciples, do the same works, perform the same actions, but to do them in secret. Then God will give his approval. God will repay you. You know, in our day and age, it's easy to get caught up in seeking the approval of others, especially through the social media. And it can be difficult for us to do some self-worth evaluations based on the opinions of other people. What will they think? What will they say? Will we still be friends? Etc. All of us have an innate desire for love, to be appreciated, to be respected, to belong. That is all a God-given gift for every single person on the face of the earth. My brothers and sisters, you and I, as Christians, are called to be countercultural. Our culture may say one thing. Our society may say one thing. But we sometimes have to stand against that. Otherwise, what's the difference between us and people who don't believe? When you read the Sermon on the Mount, chapter 5, 6, and 7 of St. Matthew, we get the point, because that's the blueprint for our Christian Catholic life. We don't do things so that we can get recognition. I think our Jesuit brothers have it right that their motto is Ad Maiorem Dei Gloriam, AMDG. Ad Maiorem Dei Gloriam, to the greater honor of God. That's it. That's the Jesuit motto. Honor and glory to God, not for ourselves. So those disciplines that Jesus mentions, prayer and fasting and almsgiving, all those Christian works, spiritual and physical works of charity, they're all meant to bring us into a right relationship with God, a right relationship with ourselves, and a right relationship with others. We don't do them to draw attention to ourselves. In a sense, you and I are called to be maybe hidden saints, without a lot of pious stuff hanging out of our portfolios. Jesus doesn't ask us to part water in the rivers, to perform any kind of a miracle. What does Jesus ask? To make a difference. To make a difference in our own world. That's what Jesus asks us to do. To make a difference in our neighborhood, in our home, in our workplace, in our country, in our church. To make a difference. Go make a difference. And right now, I am thinking that this gospel challenges us to consider how we are making a difference and perhaps to do some examination of conscience about how any of us, may have played into somehow the spreading of the cancer of racism in our own country. How do I really feel about others who are different from me? How do I really feel? This is an opportunity for us to go, as Jesus says, into your inner room. Shut the door and face it head on. Perhaps today might be a good day for us to do some soul searching. What kind of fasting? What kind of mercy? What kind of prayer is Jesus teaching us to do? Who most needs the small miracle of love that we are especially prepared to provide? Who needs it? How can I provide that support and that care? And finally, how can I most closely follow Jesus, my Master? The Lord give you peace. Let us now pray in faith for one another and for the world's needs.
For the Church, that through our sharing in the Eucharist, we may be transformed more and more into the body of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governmental and civic leaders, that God will give them wisdom to address the unrest, insight into righting the injustices, and words that will unite society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have experienced violence, that God will protect them from further harm, right the injustices that have occurred, and give them hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, that as we receive the body and blood of Christ, we may take on the mind and heart of Christ and continue the mission of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, particularly with COVID-19, and those who care for them, that God will send healing to the sick, strength and wisdom to those who care for them, and inspiration to those researching treatments and vaccines. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Frank Musinski, Dan Fleming, Florencio Mendoza, Josie Mijat, and the victims of COVID-19. We pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, you give us lasting food for body and soul. Answer our prayers as we celebrate this Eucharistic feast through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy.
Pray, sisters.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours
may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in goodness you created us, and when we were justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed us through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, with John, his assistant, with all the clergy and religious, and with all who serve the people of God. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Francis and Saint Clare, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The Savior is commanded and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now show one another a sign of Christ's peace. Peace, everybody. Peace at home, too. Can you turn around and wave to the people back there in the camera? Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Shelter me, O God, hide me in the shadow of your wings. You alone are my hope. When my foes surround me, beneath
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. Amen. So just a few words about reception of Holy Communion today. I would please like to invite you to take with you as you come up to communion any belongings, your purse, whatever, that you may have. And use the sanitizer. We're going to have two Eucharistic ministers, and one will be right there, and then one will be right over here. So you people on this side, if you would come out and use the center aisle and then go back out that way. You people on this side, if you use this aisle and then go out that way, okay? Don't be crossing in the middle of the aisle. So on this side, go out that way, receive here, and then go that way to go home that way. And this side, you go that way. You'll be receiving Holy Communion only in the hand. And please lower your mask after you receive the host. You can lower the mask to take communion, and then return your mask when you're finished. And then, of course, unfortunately, please no social gatherings outside. Thank you. The way it is. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And so let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. The sun comes out, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your songs again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes.
Bless the Lord, O my soul,
O my soul. Worship His holy name. Like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I worship Your holy name. Strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise for ending. 1,000 years and then forevermore. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, worship your holy name. I'll worship your holy name. I'll worship your holy name.
So Carrie, what's going on with this system? It couldn't even hardly hear, and then they were like, they're like in a tunnel. I don't.